God. Glorious rainy day. All right, Jesus, bless these words, and I plead the blood of Jesus over them in the name of Jesus. All right, y'all. I just had a viewer come by and had no clue, unfamiliar with God's word, y'all, unfamiliar with God. Okay, they called speaking in tongues a cult, a cultic practice. See, that's what's being taught out there. The gifts, anything that comes from God is being considered a cult. Okay, that's the days we're living in. Very unfamiliar people with God's word. All right, y'all. They said speaking in tongues is a cult. Okay, and that our language is not a curse. I'm sorry. But listen, at the Tower of Babel, there was no English or Korean or Japanese or Mexican or whatever language you want to call. That language came about because of a curse. Okay, and the only way we have redemption from that curse is through Jesus Christ. Just like we are born into sin, since Eve ate that fruit and the seeds have settled in her belly, she produced sin from every single human being born after that. Okay, the only way we have redemption through that is through Jesus Christ. Okay, you are still born a sinner. You are still born a sinner, okay? So the only way to come to redemption in Jesus Christ is through Jesus Christ, all right? So as far as the gift of tongues goes, that's a heavenly gift. Paul calls it the language of angels, okay? That's God's language, okay? And that's why it's so important that you receive that gift that God has for each one of you that's a born-again, Holy Ghost, Spirit-filled person. Because that's the language God's going to use to communicate with your spirit. Okay, it's a language Satan can't understand and that we don't understand unless he gives you the gift of interpretation. It's a gift, y'all. I told you there's many, many demons out here. Many demons and many people, many Christians, y'all, that are so unfamiliar with God, his word, and his ways. All right, let nobody deceive you. Let nobody confuse you about God and his gifts he has for you. Okay? And understand, we are still under that same curse. That's the very reason why Jesus Christ had to come and be our sacrifice. And that's the very reason, y'all, why we have to accept him. Okay? It's very important you to understand that. All right? In the name of Jesus, Google meets tonight, 8 p.m. Come learn and grow. You know, Jesus Christ explained this to me, y'all. You know, I was with him. Most of you were not. Okay, so he told me some will listen, some will not. Some accept him, some reject him, y'all. Still reject him. Do you know, it aggravates me and frustrates me as a human to watch people reject him. Do you know how it duplicates that feeling to him? He let me feel it, y'all. It's a very nasty feeling, okay? And one day coming up very soon, he showed me he's going to have to turn away from you people that rejected him. He's going to have to turn around. You're going to be screaming out to him, screaming out or apologizing. He's going to have to turn away, walk away from you, wipe his eyes, and shut the door. Do you hear me? He's going to have to shut the door and never open it again because of your rejection. And you're going to be so sorry one day that you ever, ever did that, that you rejected him. So it's time, y'all, to start realizing we serve a God who is in control, a God who still has gifts for you, and a God who came and died for you so that we can be broken from the curse, okay? But it's only through him that's going to happen, okay? In Jesus' name, God bless each one of you.